Hi students, today we will be dealing with the topic chromosomal aberration. I'm sure from the previous classes you will be now familiar and you will be thorough about the chromosome structure and the packaging details. Also, you will be familiar with all the terms like chromosome, chromatid, sister chromatid, homologous chromosome and all. And now you can move to the abnormal conditions. If you are thorough with the normal cases, now only we can go through the abnormal structures or abnormal conditions of a chromosome. So, what is a chromosomal aberration? Any change in the chromosomal structure, we call it as chromosomal aberration, or another name is chromosomal variations. Any variation from the normal conditions, we call it as aberration. So, chromosomal aberrations may be in two ways. It may be either due to the variations in the number of genes or due to the variation in their structure. So, chromosomal aberrations can be of two types, that are structural aberration and numerical aberration. Structural aberration denotes that any variation in the structure of a chromosome, that we call it as structural aberration, and any variation in the number of the genes, we call them as ploidy changes or numerical aberration. So first, let us see the structural changes. Structural changes of a chromosome may involve the gain or loss or relocation of chromosome segments or genes. So, that is, they bring the changes in the number and arrangement of genetic loci may occur there. And that will definitely have some genetic effects also, depending on the type undergone. And structural aberrations may result due to the chromosome breakages, and it may be of two types. It may be either intrachromosomal or interchromosomal. Intra means within a chromosome and inter means between a chromosome. And intrachromosomal aberrations are also called homosomal aberration, and interchromosomal aberrations are of two types. They are allelosomal aberrations and heterosomal aberrations. Allelosomal aberrations are those which occur in homologous chromosomes. If the aberration is occurring in homologous chromosome, then we call it as allelosomal aberration. And if it is occurring in non-homologous chromosome, then we call it as heterosomal aberration. So, chromosomal aberrations may be of four different types. Basically, they are deletion, duplication, inversion, and translocation. Deletion is nothing but if a segment of a chromosome is deleted, then it is deletion. And if a segment of a chromosome is duplicated, it has two copies in the same chromosome, then it is duplication. Inversion is reversal in the order of the segment, then it is inversion. Translocation is exchange in the chromosome segment, that we call it as translocation. So, structural aberrations come under four types. There are four basic types: deletion, duplication, inversion, and translocation. So, chromosomal aberration, it may be of two types: numerical aberration, which is changes in the number of genes or chromosomal segments, and structural aberrations is any changes in the structure of chromosome. And This is another flowchart representing the detail in a miniature form. Here the types of chromosomal aberrations, as we already mentioned, numerical and structural aberration. Now we are going for details of structural aberration. We were going through the details of structural aberrations, and structural aberration basically four types: deletion, duplication, inversion and translocation, and we'll be dealing with deletion only for today. So chromosomal aberrations in which alteration of the structure of chromosome occurs is known as structural aberration. And structural aberration, as we already mentioned, basically four types, and here again we can classify it under two subheadings. First is changes in the number of genes, that is structural aberrations which causes changes in number of genes are two, that are deletion and duplication. That is, deletion means a segment of a chromosome is lost, then the number of that gene is if any gene is occurring in that segment, lost segment, that gene also will be lost. So the number of genes changes. Duplication, here a segment of a gene is duplicated, so if any gene occur in that segment, we got an additional gene also. So duplication, it also changes the number of genes. Changes in the location of genes, that are of two types: inversion, if the orientation of the segment reverses, then it will be changing the location of the gene. Likewise in the case of translocation also. So first one is deletion. Deletion is the loss of a chromosomal segment together with the genes that is contained in that segment. So this deletion, it may be of two types: terminal deletion or intercalary deletion. If the segment is lost from the terminal portion of the chromosome with a single break, that is terminal deletion involves only a single break, that we call it as terminal deletion. And if it occurs in the intercalary segment, then there will be two breaks. So that type of deletion which is from the intercalary segment, that we call it as intercalary deletion. And this deletion can be of two types again: homozygous and heterozygous. That is, homozygous is the type in which a segment is lost from both the chromosomes of a homologous pair. We know there are homologous pairs, and if the deletion occurs in both the pairs, then we call it as homologous deletion. And if the deletion is occurring in only one pair of the homologous chromosome, then it is heterozygous. That is, in the homologous pair, one chromosome will be having that gene and another pair will not be having that particular gene. So that is homozygous deletion and heterozygous deletion. Here in this figure, you may be now clear with deletion through this single figure. See, this is a chromosome, normal chromosome. It has several genes, vice A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. These much of segments are there. So these much segments, it may be containing different genes also. Terminal portion is A. So this A segment is deleted in this. See, it is not having A. It starts from B, C, D, etc. up to I. So this type of deletion in which a terminal portion of a chromosome is deleted, see here only one cut is enough to remove this terminal segment, right? Only a single cut here will remove this A segment. So terminal deletions occur through a single break. So that is what a terminal deletion is. And now here you can see this D segment is missing here in this figure. So this D segment comes in between, right? So it is an intercalary segment. So this intercalary segment is removed to form this chromosome. So to remove this D segment, we have to cut the chromosome here and here. So two breaks are involved in intercalary deletion. So intercalary deletion removes this segment and it forms like this. So that is an intercalary deletion. And anything else? I think you will be now clear with all these deletion processes. And this deletion, I am saying only the mechanism. And say if there are two chromosomes like this, we have the same copy here also, that is its homologous pair also. If this deletion A is happening only in this pair, in this chromosome, and the other homologous pair which is having the A segment, then we call it as heterozygous deletion. Only one of the pair will be undergoing deletion and the other pair will be having the same gene without undergoing deletion. Then that is called heterozygous deletion if in both the homologous pairs, if the other pair also undergoes deletion of this A segment, then both the homologous pair will be having the A segment missing in them. So then that type of deletion is called homozygous deletion. And during the meiotic pairing of homologous chromosomes, those with heterozygous deletions are characteristically involve the formation of a unpaired loop or bulge in the normal chromosome. That is, the if this chromosome is pairing with the normal, its another member of the homologous pair, during meiosis, both the homologous chromosomes undergo pairing. At that time, A segment will pair with the A segment of the homologous partner, and B will pair with the B of homologous partner, C will pair with the C of homologous partner, and likewise, the whole chromosome will pair with the homologous partner. At that time, when this D segment is deleted, it becomes like this, right? Then at the time of pairing, it becomes like this. So at the time of pairing of homologous chromosomes, the homologous partner will not be having the D segment. So but the other homologous pair is having the D segment. Then that D segment will not be having any partner to pair in this chromosome. So that will form a loop. It will form a loop because it doesn't have a partner to pair. And all the rest of the segments, A pairs with A of its homologous chromosome partner, B pairs with its homologous partner, C pairs with the C segment of the homologous partner, but the D is not here. So the D of another the pair, it loops out and all other segments will be pairing. So that is a characteristic feature of heterozygous deletion. And this deletion involves the losing of genes. So it may be having several effects, and the effect of, or the genetic effect of deletion will depend on the number and means its intensity or effect will depend on the number and quality of the gene which is lost. If the lost gene is having a crucial role in the physiology and viability of gametes, then the effect will be much larger. And sometimes the deletion may be so small that it may hardly produce any detectable effect on the morphology or physiology of that organism. And there are several syndromes which result from the deletion process occurring. In human genome, deletion may result in several of the phenotypic changes, and one example we can quote is granulocytic leukemia. That particular disease is due to the deletion in the long arm of chromosome number 21. So another example is Kreidouchet syndrome. So Kreidouchet syndrome occurs due to the deletion process in the chromosome number, short arm of chromosome number 5. So you may be familiar with this Kreidouchet syndrome. Here the person or the baby will be having a cry which is similar to a cry of a cat. The baby cries like a cat mews. So they will be mentally retarded also. So this is also an example for here. You can see some figures. So this is also an example of genetic effect of deletion. So go through the topic and feel free to ask any query.